Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for today. So you got this brand new OnePlus 12R out of the box. This device having the OxygenOS 14, but yesterday I installed the most anticipated OxygenOS 15 update, which I got via OxygenOS Updater application. These updates are gradually rolling out for all the flagship series devices of OnePlus. Its list is available in the video description. In today's video, I am going to thoroughly check out each and every amazing feature of this new OxygenOS 15. So when all other OnePlus devices will get this update, you will get an idea what has been changed and the new features we got as compared to the OxygenOS 14. On the number 10th, I have shown the most amazing feature of this update, so don't miss that. Please watch this video completely. If you are new to our channel, please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon, because we always tries to provide latest update reviews, custom ROMs and the mods to unleash the true potential of your device and every tech related content that makes your device enough powerful to survive you long, even after a stock OEM stops the support. Now without further delay, let's get started. On the number 1st is the new design changes made by OnePlus as compared to the OxygenOS 14. First and my most liked feature is the two-tone color theme. This will be available under the wallpapers and style setting. If you apply this color theme, you will notice all the color icons of the system will convert into the black and white text and icons. Lots of users from last OxygenOS updates feel they are using the color OS. By using this new feature, then can feel the original OxygenOS tone up to some extent. Next is the bouncy animation everywhere in the system. You will get such animation everywhere, like while adding the widgets on the home screen, after unlocking the phone, while using the QS panel and opening the apps folder. This gives some beautiful visual and the smooth user experience of new OxygenOS 15. After OxygenOS 15, you will get different icon shapes, especially in the wallpapers and style setting. And the QS panel will have more rounded corners as compared to the previous OxygenOS 14 version. Next, we get the smooth charging animation for on-screen mode and for always-on display. In the wallpaper and style setting, for icon setting, we get two different icon packs here. They are Radiance and the Shadow. I especially liked the Shadow one, which gives the black shadow of icons. But the Radiance icon pack is a simple one, but it gives the more brighter colors to the icon. So we've seen almost all the new design changes in the OxygenOS 15. Now let's move to some useful and mesmerizing features. On the number 2nd is the live alerts. You will find this toggle under the notification and quest setting. It's similar to the iOS live updates feature. Currently it's only working for some live activities going in the phone, like timer, off clock, video recording and music tracks. All the live activities will amazingly blend into the front-facing circular camera notch. By tapping on it, we can access the current activity, or by swiping up, we can restore it back in the notch. We can stop these activities or music, we can forward or backward all the songs. If you don't want this alert notification continuously popping in the camera notch, we can swipe horizontally on the notification and it gets invisible. And if you swipe out from the camera notch, it appears back. What an amazing idea this one is. It's a proper use of status bar for easiest user interface. On the number 3rd is the new multitasking add-ons. First one is the new split screen. When you are using the split screen, you can now split the screen of the one application maximum to the 80% of the screen, while other application will split down to the bottom. Whenever we want to switch between the application, just tap on the bottom of respective application. It will split to the expanded mode, while other application will get shrinks to the bottom. We can do this vice versa whenever we want to use any split screen application for important activities to complete without completely closing the split screen. Next multitasking feature is the new floating windows. Whenever we get any application sets up notification, just swipe down the notification and it will open as a floating window of that application. We can resize the application to the any size by just dragging its corner. If you want to use the application as a full screen, just tap on the bottom bar. Or if you want to dismiss the application, just do the swipe up gesture from the bottom bar of floating window. If you want to minimize the application, just swipe to the right or the left side of the bar of the window. and it will minimizes the application to the edges of the screen. If you didn't use the application for a few minutes, the icon of the app will also slightly get sides in the curved edges of the screen. It's a pretty smart feature, na? On the number 4th is the new notification and QS panel split mode. Under the QS setting option of the setting, you will find this option. Here you get the new split mode, and another default mode is a classic one. If enables the split mode, now you can swipe down from the right corner and can access the notification panel. While swiping down from the top right corner, you can access the QS panel. You can easily switch between the notification and the QS panel by swiping left or the right. On the number 5th is the new iPhone sharing option. We'll find this under the connection and the sharing setting of the device. Toggle on the option named as the share with the iPhone. Now give all the required setting access afterwards. Now if you tries to share anything in the phone, we get this share with iPhone option. iPhone users just need to download the OnePlus Connect application and they can easily share the files between OnePlus and iPhone. On the number 6th is the new security features. First one is you can now find your device even it's power off. You can track your device using the Find My Device application. We also get the Google's new threat protection with the Android 15. This feature will lock your device when the thieves will take it from your hand and runs away, and when it is in unlock condition. Even you can lock the device in offline mode if the thieves runs and turns off the phone. We also get the remote lock and Find My Device to erase it remotely, and you can protect your data. Another is Google's new advanced Google Play Protect Scan engine. This will scan all the installed application on your device and detects any malicious or the dangerous application. On the number 7th is the new HOLO audio engine. This is available under the sound setting of the device. It has some settings to move the device audio over the front, left and the above sides by using the main and earpiece speakers. It creates the 3D effect of the music. You can check this one sample. In reality, it makes the difference. It really improves your device audio quality. On the number 8th is the new parallel processing. You will feel some performance improvement while using the widgets, opening the apps folder and switching between the application. This is because of new parallel processing, which uses the 6 different actions from the response to the scheduling of the application. These actions will be done simultaneously in the parallel way between the two applications, so they will open and respond faster. On the number 9th is the new cloud and non-cloud based AI features. There are a bunch of the features available for the AI, but in my device only one feature is working. I got working AI eraser. You can erase any object or the human things from the any picture using this feature. OnePlus now integrated AI feature for this, which will precisely detect the objects and the human things and can be removed from the pictures. It's working perfectly, but still if you check the picture carefully, you can check some mistakes happens during the process. Next AI feature is the AI blur and the glare effect for the camera. In my update, still I didn't got this feature. This feature automatically removes or adds the blur or the glare effect in the pictures that were taken using the OnePlus camera, and you can edit it using the advanced AI features. Again, if you take the pictures of the boarding passes or the passcode in the Google Photos, AI will automatically detect these pictures and gives option to add them in a Google Wallet for further use of these things. Similarly, OnePlus Notes also using the new AI assistant, which helps to format any kinds of notes we written. It cleanups and polish the text while removing any grammatical mistakes happens in the notes. OxygenOS 15 also added a new circle to search. Just long press on the navigation bar pill or the home button, select the circle to search and circle on any objects present on the screen, and Google will show the search result of that object. I only got the AI eraser feature in the editing option, others still are pending. Maybe they are only available for the non-cloud users, other will be available gradually. On the number 10th is my most favorite feature, that is called as flux theme. In the wallpapers and style setting, now get some flux themes which have some depth effect and the animation. This is similar to the iOS lock screen depth wallpaper. We can customize some part of these themes like fonts, icons, wallpapers, and always on display text and the clock styles. These themes creates amazing animation on the lock screen and on the always on display. who can customize the wallpaper styles of the text and the clocks with the depth effect. Means who can move the text above or below the subject of the wallpaper, which creates the amazing animation and visual effect. Who gets lots of presets of the theme in the More Themes option. I really liked each and every feature added by the OnePlus in the new OxygenOS 15, which helps the user to get the great multitasking, access to the running activities on the fingertips, and to customize the device to the next level without compromising the performance of the device. This is all about the OxygenOS 15. Once you get the OxygenOS OTA, you can check all these features are available for your device or not. OnePlus 12R users, if you still didn't got this update, comment in the video if you want any video tutorial for the manual flashing of this update. That's it for today guys, hope you liked my work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for the notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.